So it's day 67 at sea. I've managed 2 hours sleep, so I just have to get up to change the microplastic samples. So the times that I have to remind myself that I worked so incredibly hard to get here.
We now know so much more about microplastics in the ocean around Antarctica, thanks to a record-breaking sailor, Lisa Blair, who not only broke a speed record while sailing, but also investigated microplastics at the same time. So how long were you actually sailing around Antarctica for?
Yeah, so it was 92 days at sea in the Southern Ocean.
We just had another storm come through.
And on the trip, with all the microplastics that I gathered, it actually ended up being the largest microplastic survey of the Antarctic region to ever take place.
So the science is going on in here?
Yeah, so it's inside, yeah.
Okay, and you've just got the results back from that.
Yeah.
What are the results in terms of the microplastics in Antarctica?
And it's pretty devastating. We found plastic in every single sample, the whole way around Antarctica. So just to give an example of microplastics, this is a standard bottle cap that's been washed overboard. And when it breaks down at sea, it turns into microplastics. So that becomes that. And then that goes out into our ecosystem and gets eaten by the little crustaceans, the krill, the small critters, and goes into our food chain.
In the last season of War and Waste, we learnt we consume roughly a ping pong sized ball of microplastic every year. So what do we do about this? What are the solutions to this?
So we found 64% of all the samples around Antarctica was microfiber. So you can try to buy like more natural material clothing, so your cotton, your hemp fibers, rather than your polyester and your nylon synthetic fibers. But being mindful of what we're doing with our washing machines, so every load of laundry that we do, we're releasing microplastics into our waste treatment system and then into the sea. So you can do things like install a filter on your washing machine.
Well, I noticed the boat's called Climate Action Now.
Yeah.
What's the kind of post-it note look going on here?
Each message is an environmental action from someone in our communities on something they're already doing towards a better future. And the goal is to just show people that as an individual, we do have the power to create change. I'm one girl, one person. I decided to sail one ocean and look at the impact I've generated.
To have just spent 3 months surviving in the Southern Ocean, going through snowstorms and blizzards past Iceberg Alley, sailing through waves the size of a 3 or 4 story building. Today, I'm actually crossing my outgoing track and becoming the first woman in history to do so. So it's a pretty historical moment for me.